Howdy, and welcome back to Frickin' Sports. I am your host, Cody, and today we are going to be recapping the Atlanta Braves series. And so let's start with game one, right? So, game one, I think Jake Woodford was decent at starting. Obviously, he had a little bit of a tough break, and I think he's a younger pitcher, so he did start to settle in too, which is good to see. You want to see your pitchers, even if they have a rough bit, you know, settle in. And so he settled in, and I wasn't able to watch the whole game, but I really liked what I saw from these players. And Atlanta is a tough lineup. I mean, you got Acuna, you got Matt Olson. Like, you got some tough players in there, and it's not going to be an easy walkthrough. And yes, that was also the same that we had with Toronto. They were a tough lineup too. Frankly, I don't know how we got through that with two lower scoring games against them. It was a little strange, but again, there's ebbs and flows in a Cardinal season, or in a baseball season, so, you know, contribute that to it. This was also Woodford's first start this season, so, you know, but he settled in, and I saw him adjust, and I liked that. Now, the offense started slow, and it seemed that the Braves kind of let the Cardinals back into that game. Now, obviously, we didn't get fully in back in, so, but we did start to come back, but then they also scored back again. So, overall, 8-4 loss. It's tough, but that's just how it goes sometimes. So, yesterday's game. You know, that one, I wasn't able to watch. I had to work. But, I know the big headline was Tyler O'Neill, running home and not making it, and then Ollie making some comments about it, and Tyler making some comments about it, and they're butting heads. I will recap that situation in the episode after this. It will be posted tomorrow after this episode airs. But basically, I think if in that spot where it is late innings, you know, we could have come back into that game and won. But we ended up losing 1-4. So if that didn't happen, you know, maybe we come back and we win, but you never know. It's really tough for you to kind of project that. But tough loss nonetheless. You know, rough pitching debut and plus we faced a rookie, so, you know, it's, my takeaway is that our offense can be good, and we're not out of most games, and it didn't feel like we would be out of that game. You know, didn't obviously get the rally to come back, but it's unfortunate that, like, we didn't, and we also faced a rookie, so we don't have any data on them, so, and it was their first debut, so, you know, it's the beginning of the season. It's a long season. There's going to be games where we just are bad. And honestly, I thought the offense was, even though we didn't produce, it didn't feel like we were out of a game. We kept getting into these spots where we got runners on. Now, maybe we left people on base, which is a whole other issue. But when you get people on base, sometimes things won't happen, and sometimes things will. So, just as long as that happens, I'm I'm good with that. So that game, it's a little bit rough. It's gonna be a little bit of a sore subject for a little bit, but you know, moving on. So today's game, Tyler O'Neill got benched because of the game prior. And again, I will talk about that next episode, but he did come in to pinch hit, and I'm just going to say that I think that what this series taught us is that we need more pitching. We need an ace. I mean, Michaelis is our number one starter, and he got beaten up this game. I mean, sometimes it happens, right? But we need pitching, and I'm going to emphasize this enough. We have such a deep lineup. A deep, deep lineup. And yet we don't have that deep of a... I forgot the name. Forget it. I don't know. Deep pitching, you know? Our bullpen has been performing really good, though. And I wouldn't say that they're that deep of a bullpen, but I liked what I've seen from them so far, so I won't get into that. Like, I think they've kept us in the games. Especially against a tough lineup, and that whole series we couldn't get the 1, 2, and 3 hitters off the base, which they were just hot. So sometimes you run into that in a series, and it's just not great. But you know, this is a tough team. They're gonna be one of the top teams in the NL East or NL. You know, so this is going to be a team we'll see in the future. Hopefully they're not as hot then, especially if we see them in the postseason. So, you know, live and learn. But I think there's some highlights. You know, Jordan Walker got his first home run, and I thought that was great for him. He's showing all of his talent now, and I love seeing it. Like, this kid can play. He's 20. He's only a year older than me, which is crazy. So that this kid is playing at a high level at 20, and he looks comfortable in the bat, in the, you know, he looks comfortable with all this, and it's really interesting to me because, you know, he's a rookie. Like, he looks like he's experienced it, or a veteran. So, you know, I'm excited for the future. Tough sweep to be by the Braves, but it's gonna happen. We face the Brewers next. You know, short-term memory. Let's not remember this series and go on to Milwaukee and let's give them hell. You know, so hope you all enjoyed this video or audio, depending on how you are listening to the Frickin' Frackin' Sports Podcast, whether that's on YouTube, Spotify, or Apple Podcasts. So, hope you all enjoyed that. Horns down, Boomer Sooner. Let's go, Cardinals. See y'all next time. Deuces.